The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. The light of Christ, raising in glory, dispels the darkness of our hearts, our minds, and our world, and has gathered us in the circle of mercy, together as friends, family, faculty, and staff, and most importantly, our class of 2022. As we celebrate your accomplishments and commission you forth to be that light into the world. So before we do so, in this Easter day, we bless water and sprinkle ourselves with water as a sign of a new beginning, the sign of new creation. And so let us pray now for this blessing. Lord our God, in your mercy, be present to your people who keep this day most sacred. And for us who recall the wondrous work of our creation and still the greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water. May this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share the gladness of our sisters and brothers always. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please remain standing.
Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
you are the light of the world. The light that dispels the darkness of our hearts, our minds, and our world. The light that can fill us and put away the rain. The light that can transform the world into a better place. The light that can actually gather people in rather than scatter them. Right? The light that invites people into the circle of mercy. Invites them into relationship, into a sense of belonging that we all so desperately crave. You, Mary and Mercy Academy, class of 2022, you are the light of the world. That's what Jesus says. Right here. Meant to be shined all over. But if we're honest with ourselves, we often at times feel overwhelmed by the darkness. It seems like too much, right? We often report feeling less like light. You know, insecurities come up, difficulties come up, difficult situations in our lives, the rain starts happening, right? The light seems a little dim at times. We forget who we are in the eyes of God. That is the light. And so often we need to plug back in, recharge ourselves so that our light might get brighter for the world. So that we might meet a need in the world that the world so desperately needs from you and from me. For your task as light to set the world on fire with mercy is meeting a crucial need in the world. Because so often our world is more downcast. It's more darkness. You feel overwhelmed by it. And so your task is even more important. This has actually been researched. Anyone know Brene Brown? Okay, yeah, a few people. Brene Brown, an American researcher, psychologist, and author. She was she studies a lot of things. And she studies connection, she studies human emotion, she studies empathy, vulnerability, shame, those sorts of things, fear. And as she did all her research interviews, she came to find that the one thing that kept creeping up in all the research, in thousands of interviews, was the universal need to belong, to feel connected, to feel seen. And so she was confused by this, and then she started to see it correlated. Those who didn't feel like they belonged reported more suffering than others. So what is going on here? So she asked these people, what does this look like? What does this mean? What do you experience the world than that? And they said, it's more negative. It's more us versus them. It's more division, right? It's more of a lack of our shared humanity with one another. It's not belonging. And what people actually reported was more of the pressure to fit in, to conform, to be someone else than to belong. To dim their light rather than let it shine. So then she's trying to figure this out. She goes, well, what's the difference between fitting in and belonging? So she asked 8th grade students, and their answers are brilliant.
I'm going to share them with you.
8th grade students said this. Belonging is being somewhere where you want to be and they want you to be there too. Fitting in is being somewhere where you want to be, but they really don't care whether you're there or not. Hatred. We know that. 7th student, belonging is being accepted for you with your gifts, your growing edges, your insecurities. Fitting in is being accepted for being like everyone else. And the last student, if I get to be me, fully me, I belong. If I have to be like you, I simply fit in. For this is what people report is most like their experience. But the good news of Jesus Christ, the good news of Mary and Mercy Academy today, is that Christ comes into this space in the spirit of the Mercy Sisters, surrounded by faculty and staff, surrounded by family and friends, and says, don't forget that you are the light of the world. it's going to be really, really bright. Merciful God, you stand by us always. You nourish us with your word, feed us with your very body and blood, and shed your light within us. We desire to follow you and give glory to your name. Help us to give as you have given to us, and not hold back, as we sing your praise with all those who feast in faith. As your light in the world, we make this prayer in gratitude and hope. Amen. Please be seated to prepare our gifts. Thank you.
power of this sacrifice, and with constant trust in Christ, you may come to eternal life through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, the universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Nelson, our Bishop, all those who lead and serve your people. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with all the saints, with Catherine Macaulay, and all those who have pleased you throughout the ages, you may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever.
Amen.
into the world to bring that light to others. Let us pray now as that light, as one mind and heart, using Jesus' words. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, merciful God, that nourished by the body and blood of your Son, we may draw confidently from the wellsprings of mercy and show ourselves ever more compassionate towards our sisters and brothers through Christ our Lord. For our final blessing, I'd like to do something a little bit unique. I'd like those who are the students here to simply bow your heads. I'd like everyone else to fill this room by repeating after me, as well as extending your hands as a sign of calling upon the Holy Spirit to bless these graduates. Since they're up front and you're kind of far away, you've got to be real loud now, all right? So that if anyone's at Waldron, they'll hear you. So repeat after me, please, nice and loud. May God bless you.
May Graduation of my on for forever. Okay. Do you want me to hold this
for you?
There is so much
okay.
Meat on this. No, no, it's okay. No, it's okay, Mom. You need a picture. I just need to recreate.
She needs
a
picture
for Megan's
pre-K
graduation.
I want to toss
you.
You toss your hat,
too.
I want to toss you.
Oh my God. No, let's see. No, Mom, I'm not doing it.
Do you want a family picture up
no.
there?
Because
I'll take it. Because I'll take it.
I said it in the beginning of this because, like,
where is that?
got that one.